Apr to play. Also in last night's doubleheader at the Barbados Community College Gym, Pan American International Insurance Warrens dealt a serious blow to Barbados Lumber Company Lakers' chance of making the playoffs. CBC's Anne-Marie Burke reports on that game.
By halftime, up 40-36, and the aim was to maintain the advantage. Jamar King outside the arc, making it a big three. Lakers on the other end was intent on keeping it a tight battle. Mark Brashman sinking that one. Lakers again, Jariah Rock on the break, passes off to Jamal Singh, who sure enough finished it up off the board. You can say the Lakers offense meant business. Brashman to Greg Jones, who made it a one-hand dunk. Yup, Jones was the man with a game-high 33 points. But Warren subbed in their secret weapon, the name Zaire Matara, on the night, the three-point boss. Matara, out for his first game of the season, was clearly on fire. That's another three. As Warriors held a two-point lead at the end of the third, 57-55. So the last 15 minutes will be all to play for both sides. Lakers making sure all hands on deck with the rebound, Jones mops it up. But remember Matara? No, he was just dishing out the points. Two here and the foul. Dario Kamabash with the steal, Matara collects it, and sure enough, he nails it. That's his third big one. Lakers were getting on the act too. Brashman, he contributed 13 on the night. Now Matara was really the point man for the Warriors. Could this steal amount to up? Yup, just what I thought, another three. But it was the scoreline that made the game interesting now. This three from Brashman put the Lakers in command, up on the board 80-77. But what happened next turned the game upside down. Lakers with possession, looking for the three. Then again the pass, stolen by King, who then passes off to Matara, who does what he does best. He sinks it, and watch the clock go. All tied up with 15 seconds remaining. Warren's with possession, and King takes it. What does he do? Pulls up for a big one, and it goes in. Warriors in full pandemonium. They celebrate the 83-80 victory. Anne-Marie Burke, CBC Sports.
Thank you, Anne-Marie. DirecTV Paradise is holding on to a one-point lead at the top of the Digicel BFA Premier League on 30 points, along with UWI Blackbirds. Playing at the BFA AstroTurf last night, Paradise defeated Rendezvous 3-2.
Rendezvous here in blue and yellow against Paradise. Shandell Samuel controls it and hammers it home. Wow! 1-0 in the 29th. Free kick at the edge of the box. Great idea, but not quite the execution. Opportunity for Paradise now from a dead ball situation, but can't keep it down. But they would pull one back on the stroke of halftime. Awful, awful by the goalie. Are you serious, guy? Neural George makes it 1-1 at the break. 72nd minute, Paradise with a free kick. How about that? Armando Lashley with a beauty, 2-1. And just 1 minute later, Lashley got his brace to make it free. Paradise in front. Then in the 85th minute, this happened. Didn't look like a whole lot of contact to me, but the ref said that's a penalty. Samuel stepped up and converted, got his second, but it was too little too late. Final score, Paradise 3, Rendezvous 2.
Meanwhile, the Barbados Defence Force sports program are sitting in third spot on 29 points after registering a 4-3 win over Britain's Hill. Two goals from Shaquille Boyce and one apiece from Shaquille Stewart and Mario Williams secured the win for the BDFSP. Mustafa Hack slotted home twice for Britain's Hill and Tashane Lord added one. In the night's other game, Lumisol Technology Inc. Pinelands and Empire played to a 3-3 draw. The third edition of the Hamilton Lashley Foundation Caribbean Children's Charity Shield will take place between August 24th and 29th in Guyana. A delegation from the foundation visited Guyana ahead of the tournament and was received by President David Granger, who agreed to lend support. Tricia Brown headed that delegation.
This year, because both Guyana and Barbados are celebrating their 50 years of independence, we decided to take it to Guyana. Going to Guyana, we have 10 teams from Barbados. We have 10 clubs, and these clubs, some include both under 17 and under 14 teams. Then we have 5 teams from Guyana will be participating, 5 from Suriname, and 1 from Brazil, 9 teams from Trinidad.
Patron of the foundation, Hamilton Lashley, revealed that this year's competition will be held in the honor of recently deceased sports reporter Petra Gooden. He also explained how the Shield came about.
The concept of the tournament began in Trinidad and Tobago when I was sent on a mission by government. But I met with the NGO sector, particularly coming out of Laventille and Morvan, areas in Trinidad and Tobago that they call socially depressed areas. And the whole idea was that we have an exchange program among communities in the Caribbean. And we find using sports as that medium to create that kind of synergies of communities across the region.
Barbadian jockey Delano Lopez rode favorite Lucky Stranger to victory at the feature race at the Arima Racetrack in Trinidad and Tobago over the weekend, going 1,750 meters and carrying a purse of $60,000 TT. Lopez gave the owners of the 2016 Gold Cup winner Dorset another big victory.
Racing! Nice start for everyone, including Buffalo Soldier in between runners. And also showing speed is Holy Man on the outside. And here comes Lucky Stranger on the inside together with Scotus. That's the top two. And they're being followed by Buffalo Soldier. Holy Man widest of all of the yellow colors as they move around the first corner, making their way to the 1,400-meter marker. And Lucky Stranger is taking them along together with Scotus. Then Buffalo Soldier. After Buffalo Soldier, the one on the inside, and that's one for the road. One for the road has Holy Man for company. Then Secret American Bergeron Rodeo is 3 from last, back to Biengabi's Gold and American Ranger. So that's the field in the 7th race here at Santa Rosa Park as they make their way up to the 1,000-meter pole. And Lucky Stranger, the leader, leads by a length. In second spot is Cotus. Here comes Holy Man coming in between runners, moved into third spot just ahead of one for the road. Then comes Buffalo Soldier, is under the shove already. After Buffalo Soldier is Secret American. Then a long gap back to Bergeron Rodeo. Gabi is Gold and American Ranger, they are next as they move to the far turn with 700 meters to travel. And the one on the outside, that's our Lucky Stranger, who still has the call. Holy Man is being shoved out in second. On the inside is one for the roads. Cotus is starting his run on the outer. He is now into second spot as Lucky Stranger goes now. Lucky Stranger goes on by 2 lengths. Cotus second, Holy Man third, then one for the road, then Secret American as they straighten up to the judge. And the one to catch is the favorite Lucky Stranger. Ranger by 3 lengths, and second spot is Cotus. Then comes Secret American, Holy Man is done. Then comes the other one is American Ranger. But it's all about Lucky Stranger with just about 100 meters to go. And Lucky Stranger has put this race to bed in some style. He's been punched right out to get the job done. Tight for second, maybe Cotus over the stain on American Ranger.
Now to tonight's Olympic moment. And it was one of the proudest ones for Trinidad and the region.
Olympic Moments, brought to you by Sagicor General Insurance, Sandals Barbados, and Good Time Snacks. Montreal, 1976. Hazley Crawford of Trinidad and Tobago had the distinction of being the first Olympic 100-meter champion from a Caribbean country. From the outside, in lane number one, Crawford took gold in a time of 10.06 seconds, just ahead of Don Quarry of Jamaica, thus winning Trinidad's first Olympic gold medal. During his reign as the Olympic champion, he was awarded Trinidad and Tobago's highest honor, the Trinity Cross, and this was in 1978. Now, that award was changed to the Order of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago sometime later. In 2000, he was named the Trinidad and Tobago Athlete of the Millennium, and he's also a member of the Caribbean Hall of Fame. Olympic Moments, brought to you by Sagicor General Insurance, Sandals Barbados, and Good Time Snacks.
Now sports, the business report is next.
Community Files.